And it's race time for the Chinese Grand Prix.
Good day today. Let's have your take on it. We've not seen much development progression for your car recently. Why is that? How's your grid penalty going to affect your strategy going into the race? Great. Well, that's everything.
Currently, race is up to 20% distance.
So, unfortunately, we've picked up some grid penalties, and we'll be starting further back than you'd expect. As for how bad it is, that'll depend on what the other drivers get.
Weather forecast, rain.
Time to find out which driver is up to the task of claiming the Chinese Grand Prix. We're here in Shanghai. The ever-tightening turns 1 and 2 will prove tricky in the slippery conditions here at Shanghai, and anyone that slides wide will lose a lot of time getting back on track. Turn 14 should still be the best place for overtaking, but we'll have to see some improvement in the weather before the drivers can take advantage of that DRS assistance. Joining us today to oversee all the thrills and spills, it's Anthony Davidson. Ant, great to see you. How are you feeling about the race today, and how are the circuit conditions from what you've seen?
Well, the surface looks clean enough, but I'm a little bit worried about the track temperature. It's pretty cool out there, which could give some teams difficulties when it comes to keeping their tyres in the right operating window. The cars out there that work their tyres hard and really put a lot of energy through them, they'll be the ones that are better off.
Let's run you through the driver grid order for today's exciting race. Sebastian Vettel will start on pole. Fantastic qualifying from the multiple world champion. Edging out Devon Butler, who'll start from P2. Considering the rest of the grid, we have Weber, Hamilton, Max Verstappen, Harris, Norris, Sainz, Hülkenberg, and Daniel Ricciardo.
I've got a 5-place penalty, so I start 5th on the grid.
Fiat, Perez, Romain Grosjean, and George Russell, Giovinazzi, and Robert Kubica takes the last spot on the grid. Now it's almost time to lights out, so let's go down to the track.
After the points finish last race, let's aim to keep the momentum going.
Drive more conservatively to increase the lifespan of each tyre set, reducing the amount of pit stops required. Zero pit stops, 14 laps, or low tyre management. Get out of here. Vehicle condition.
Line that front wing. It'll need replacing if it takes too much damage. Alright, we expect these tyres to be good for a while yet. Just be careful with them in the high-speed corners.
Wet conditions make it much different.
That's a decent start. Good job.
Get it saved. This is bad stuff.
Okay, some information on signs. They have some kind of mechanical problem.
That's why I saved it.
Go away.
Okay, some information on signs. They seem to have an issue.
Shit!
Still on the right tyres for the time being. Is plus one. Faster engine modes are available. Top 10 now. Keep it up. They're speeding up again, so I expect they fixed whatever the problem was.
got to be a lot more careful over the wet, you've got no choice.
Front is 7.4 seconds. Trailing our teammate by 8.8 seconds. The car behind is dropping back. We're seeing a gap form.
last one is green. Too screen, I lost time on that corner.
Is 8.0 seconds.
I'm not closing it. That's a nice stretch. What the real drivers can do, of course, is do this. Let's pause, have a stretch, save the mid-session. goodness knows what this is like on 100% race distance. Using a controller, not a wheel.
There's 4 laps of fuel remaining. Gap to teammate ahead is 12.7 seconds. This light rain is going to be with us for a while now.
Yeah, until the end of the race.
Laps of fuel remaining. We expect the grip levels to start falling away soon. Gap to car in front is 7.5 seconds.
God damn.
You've been awarded a time penalty for that last incident.
Lewis Hamilton sets the fastest lap. Thank you.
behind is dropping back by about 3/10 a lap.
That's all I need.
This is your final lap of the race.
Very eventful at the start with all the cars going around the first two corners. And the rest of the race.
Okay, we're monitoring somewhere on the ICE. Be aware that we will start to see a loss of power.
Not yet. Not now. The rest of the race is basically just trying to hold position. Somebody's out for the session. Lewis Hamilton sets the fastest lap as he wins. Checkered flag.
Bad luck. It just wasn't our day today.
What do you mean? Lewis Hamilton came first and I came fifth.
This result, do you think?
Well, they clearly have a car that comes alive in the kind of conditions we were dealing with today. It's a very balanced package in the wet, and what that means is that the drivers have confidence to attack, and having that confidence gets you on the power earlier, it lets you brake later, and can put you a long way up the road.
So after a magnificent race, we can now see the drivers making their way to the podium. Once again, it's the Silver Arrows who take top spot, a well-earned victory for Mercedes.
Copyright music.
And after this round of the World Championship, here's how things look in the driver's table. It's a great result for Lewis Hamilton, who moves further ahead at the top of the table. So, Anthony Davidson, who would you rank as your driver of the day?
Well, it's got to be Kevin Magnussen. He displayed exceptional skill out on the track today and wasn't afraid to fight his way through the pack.
It's time to see how things are shaping up in the Constructors' Championship. Mercedes continue to extend their lead. There was also a strong showing from the McLaren team today as they make their way up the standings. It's been an absolutely wild weekend of Formula One action. I can't wait to see what's next.
What a replay of the start. Tricky conditions in the wet.
Work out there today. Let's have your thoughts. Do you have any comments about the collisions? Your former teammate Lucas just moved ahead of you in the points. What happened?
Well, gee, I've got a choice here, haven't I?
Wasn't much between you and Lucas by the finish today. How do you feel the weather affected the outcome today? Appreciate your time.
Remember to select a driver that you consider your rival from the rivalry screen on the workstation. Performing well against your rival can earn you respect and better terms when it comes to our contract reviews.
Looks like one of your rivals has also been invited to a historical event. This could be a good opportunity to play up your rivalry for the press and expand your reputation.
Slipped a rival.
Here you can see a list of eligible drivers to declare as your rival. The more challenging they are to beat, the more the paddock will respect you for succeeding. Just be aware, you'll lose the same amount of respect if you come off second best. So it may be wise not to be overly cautious.
It's got to be Devin Buckner, of course, because of his attitude.
Thank you.
And I'll end the session here. Thanks for watching. See you next time.